Hello student, good morning. Today we will discuss about the LC oscillations. LC oscillations in chapter AC circuit. LC oscillation. LC oscillation or LC circuit. It means that we connect an inductor as well as a capacitor to a AC circuit. Then the oscillations performed in the circuit is called as the LC oscillation. We know that in electrostatic chapter we have already discussed that the capacitor is used to store the energy and also inductor is used to store the energy. Capacitor is used to store electrostatic energy as well as a magnetic inductor is used to store the energy in magnetic field. Now what happens when these two inductor and capacitor are connected? Suppose this is a circuit here, inducting coil is connected and here a capacitor is connected. C is the capacitance of capacitor and L is the inductance of the inductor. Here we can show the positive charge on one of the plate of capacitor and another plate contains negative charges. One plate of capacitor has a positive polarity and second plate of capacitor has a negative polarity. Now, when a full charged capacitor is connected to inductor, here full charged capacitor is connected to the inductor, the charge is transferred. Charge is transferred to the inductor. When fully charged capacitor is connected to the inductor, the charge is transferred to the inductor or through the and current passes through the circuit. And when this current start to flow, the current varies when our current changes. When there is a change in current and due to current passing through this inducting coil, a magnetic field developed around this coil, and due to this magnetic field and when there is a change in current, then there is a change in magnetic field also, and due to change in magnetic field, the magnetic flux passing through this coil also changes. And by the Lenz law we know that when there is a change in magnetic flux, EMF induces in this coil. EMF induces in this coil and induced EMF opposes this current due to this charged capacitor. And due to this opposition, the capacitor gets charged or start to discharge. Start to discharge. And the electrostatic energy of capacitor start to decreases. As the electrostatic energy decreases in the capacitor, the energy in the inductor increases in same amount. Jevda ya tikani capacitor madli energy ya tikani decrease hote, tevdi energy ya tikani inductor madhe kay hote, increase hote. Due to the self induced EMF track or opposed to growth of current in the inductor. A same amount of energy is stored in the inductor in the form of magnetic field. जेवढी एनर्जी या ठिकाणी आता इथं काय होतं सेल्फ इंडक्शन होतं आणि सेल्फ इंडक्शन झाल्यामुळं दिस अपोजेस द करंट फ्लो ऑफ करंट आणि फ्लो ऑफ करंटला अपोज केल्यामुळं जी कॅपॅसिटरची एनर्जी आहे ती काय होते डिक्रीज व्हायला सुरुवात होते आणि जसजशी इथली एनर्जी डिक्रीज व्हायला सुरुवात होते तसतशी इंडक्टर मधली एनर्जी इंक्रीज होते अँड दिस एनर्जी इज स्टोअर्ड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ मॅग्नेटिक फील्ड. द एनर्जी स्टोअर्ड इन द कॅपॅसिटर इज इन फॉर्म ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोस्टॅटिक फील्ड और इलेक्ट्रोस्टॅटिक एनर्जी. अँड देन अगेन फेल दिस कॅपॅसिटर डिस्चार्ज कंप्लीटली देन द एनर्जी इन द कॅपॅसिटर विल बी झिरो अँड द एनर्जी इन द इंडक्टर इज मॅक्झिमम. याच्यामधली एनर्जी काय असेल त्यावेळेला मॅक्झिमम असेल. फेन डिस्चार्जिंग ऑफ कॅपॅसिटर कम्प्लीट ऑल द एनर्जी स्टोअर इन द कॅपॅसिटर विल स्टोअर इन द इंडक्टर ऍज रिझल्ट ऑफ दिस द इंडक्टर विल स्टार्ट चार्जिंग. इंडक्टर काय होईल त्याच्यामुळे चार्ज होईल और ड्यू टू द एनर्जी इन द इंडक्टर विल स्टार्ट टू चार्ज द कॅपॅसिटर अगेन अँड देन अगेन करंट फ्लोज इन द सेम डायरेक्शन अँड दिस इंडक्टर विल चार्ज द कॅपॅसिटर अँड ड्यू टू द चार्जिंग द कॅपॅसिटर देन द पोलॅरिटी ऑफ दिस प्लेट्स विल बी चेंजेस देन निगेटिव्ह प्लेट बिकम अ पॉझिटिव्ह अँड पॉझिटिव्ह चार्ज प्लेट बिकम अ निगेटिव्ह चार्ज अँड दिस प्रोसेस रिपीट द प्रोसेस ऑफ चार्जिंग अँड डिस्चार्जिंग ऑफ कॅपॅसिटर इज रिपीटेड अँड एनर्जी टेकन फ्रॉम द सोर्स कीप्स ऑसोलेटिंग. फर्स्ट एट ऑल अ कॅपॅसिटर स्टार्ट टू डिक्रीज देन एनर्जी इन द कॅपॅसिटर इज ट्रान्सफर टुवर्ड्स द इंडक्टर then the energy in the inductor it utilizes to charge the capacitor then again this inductor charge the capacitor but polarity is in the different direction up to full complete charge the current flows in the same direction when polarity or when the energy in the inductor is transferred towards the capacitor in the form of electrostatic energy then the polarity of this plate changes. This repeats again and again. Capacitor gets charged and gets discharged, charged and discharged and due to this the circuit oscillates. The energy of the circuit changes electrostatic energy in magnetic field energy and magnetic field energy into electrostatic energy and due to this the process the charging of discharging of capacitor is repeated and energy taken from source keeps oscillating between the capacitor and inductor. Now we will discuss about different stage of this. In first case here we have discussed that this is positive polarity, this is negative polarity of capacitor, this is the inductor, this is the direction of flow of current and the electrical energy stored in a electrostatic medium between the plates of capacitor is given by equation U is equal to 1 by 2 Q naught square upon C. U is the electrostatic energy, Q is the charge on the capacitor and C is the capacitance of the capacitor. Q is the charge on the one of the plate of the capacitor. At first the capacitor has a charge of Q naught. At first time capacitor has a charge of Q naught on one plate. At the time t is equal to 0, at t is equal to, initially time t is equal to 0, where fully charged capacitor is connected to the inductor of inductance L. Since there is no current in the circuit, the energy stored in the magnetic field of inductor is 0. And when this connect to the inductor, the flow of charges start and EMF induces in this inductor, and induced EMF opposes the flow of current, and due to this opposition the capacitor start to discharge, and capacitor, the energy in the capacitor is transferred to the inductor, and due to this the circuit start oscillating. Now in second case, here we can show that the charge on the capacitor goes on decreasing. And the magnetic field developed around this coil can be shown as this type. I is the current passing through the circuit, positive pole to negative pole to the capacitor. As the circuit is closed, the capacitor begins discharge. In this case, we can say this is the figure B. Capacitor begins discharge itself through the inductor, giving rise to the current I in the circuit. In this case, there is a no flow of current. In this case, current will start to flow and the charge on the capacitor goes on decreases. And due to the change in the current, the EMF induces in this coil, and the part of electrical energy of the capacitor get stored in the inductor in the form of magnetic energy, and therefore this magnetic energy is given by the equation U is equal to 1 by 2 L I square. U is equal to 1 by 2 L I square. And here we can write B for the magnetic field. Here the electrostatic field or electrical energy, this is the magnetic field energy. Now in case third, we can show the capacitor is fully discharged. The capacitor is fully discharged. There is no charge on this capacitor. Current flow in the same direction, and the magnetic field developed around this coil, it will be the maximum. This is the magnetic field developed around this coil. Capacitor is completely discharged in this case. Figure C, we can say that the capacitor is fully discharged. At the later instant, the capacitor gets fully discharged and potential difference across this place becomes the 0. Here is a no potential difference across this capacitor. The potential difference is equal to 0. potential difference is equal to zero because there is no charge stored on the capacitor. Capacitor is completely discharged and therefore total energy of capacitor is transferred to the inductor and therefore potential difference across these two plates is zero. And the current reaches its maximum value, that is current as maximum value of I naught passing through the inductor. The energy in magnetic field is given by equation. This equation here, energy continuously changes by this 1 by 2 L I square. I is the instantaneous current and here in this case I is the maximum current which it passes through this. Here I is the current at this instant and we can write the energy UV is equal to 1 by 2 L R naught square. Maximum current will pass through the circuit and therefore U, that is magnetic field energy, is equal to 1 by 2 L R naught square. Then again, after the discharge of capacitor is complete, the magnetic flux linked with the inductor decreases, inducing a current in the same direction as earlier current. The current this persists but with discharge in the magnitude. Charges of capacitor is opposite direction. Now we can write a figure D as this type. The energy in this inductor, start to charging the capacitor and the charge increases. But the polarity is in opposite direction. Here the charge increases. Current is in the same direction. Current will be in same direction. Here I is the current. In this case, direction of current is same. But the polarity of capacitor plate is changed. The energy in this capacitor start to charge the capacitor and therefore the magnetic field energy is converted or start to convert in the electrostatic energy and the inductor begin to charge into the electric static energy of the capacitor. As the capacitor goes on charging, when the capacitor is fully charged, then we get the condition as this side. Here the capacitor is full charged. We can show the charge on the capacitor as this type, but polarity of charge on the plate is different as that of the first case. And here is the inductor. आता या केस मध्ये काय झालं, हळूहळू कॅपॅसिटरचं चार्ज व्हायला सुरुवात झाली. चार्ज होत असताना करंटचं डायरेक्शन तेच असणार आहे, फक्त प्लेटवरची जी चार्जची पोलॅरिटी आहे ती मात्र या ठिकाणी चेंज झालेली आहे. या ठिकाणी जो इंडक्टर आहे त्यातली जी कम्प्लिटली जी एनर्जी आहे मॅग्नेटिक फील्ड एनर्जी, ती टोटली या ठिकाणी इलेक्ट्रोस्टॅटिक एनर्जीमध्ये कन्वर्ट झालेली आहे. आणि या ठिकाणी हा जो कॅपॅसिटर आहे तो कम्प्लिटली चार्ज झालेला आहे, म्हणजेच ह्याला चार्ज करण्यासाठी हे इंडक्टरमधली एनर्जी या ठिकाणी काय झालेली आहे, ते युटिलाइज झालेली आहे. म्हणजे इथली एनर्जी आता सध्या झिरो झाली आणि इथली कॅपॅसिटर काय झाला, कम्प्लीट चार्ज झाला. आणि कॅपॅसिटर ज्यावेळेस कम्प्लीट चार्ज होतो त्यावेळेस परत या ठिकाणी ह्या इंडक्टरला कनेक्ट केल्यामुळं या ठिकाणी परत करंट फ्लो व्हायला सुरुवात होते आणि करंटचं जे डायरेक्शन आहे ते मात्र आता या ठिकाणी काय होतं, चेंज होतं. द डायरेक्शन ऑफ करंट चेंजेस व्हेन द कॅपॅसिटर इज फुली चार्ज. द डायरेक्शन ऑफ is opposite that of the first case. First figure मध्ये direction जे होतं त्याचे opposite मध्ये या ठिकाणी direction current चा असणार आहे. अशा पद्धतीने कॅपॅसिटर परत रिपीट होणार. देन कॅपॅसिटर अगेन स्टार्ट टू फ्लो द करंट थ्रू द इंडक्टर एंड देन द ईएमएफ विल बी इंड्यूस्ड इन द इंडक्टर एंड ईएमएफ इंड्यूस्ड इन दिस इंडक्टर विल अपोज द फ्लो ऑफ करंट एंड देयरफॉर द एनर्जी इन द कैपेसिटर देन अगेन स्टार्ट टू डिक्रीज एंड देयर टोटल एनर्जी ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक एनर्जी स्टोर्ड इन द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड एनर्जी and then again capacitor will discharge and this process will repeat again and again. That is, at every cycle or every stage the capacitor will charge and discharge again and again, and this process will be repeated again and again. That is, we can say that the electrostatic energy is converted into magnetic energy is converted into electrostatic energy, and this process repeated, and due to this repetition or conversion of electrostatic energy into magnetic and magnetic energy into electrostatic energy, the oscillations create in the circuit, and these oscillations are called as the ELC oscillations. Entire energy stored in the capacitor is given by this equation, that is 1 by 2 Q naught upon K, Q naught square upon K. Thus, energy of the system continuously surges back and forth between the electric field and magnetic field. And this produces the oscillations, electric oscillations of definite frequency due to the charge and discharge of capacitor and the conversion of electrostatic energy into magnetic energy into electrostatic energy. The oscillations creates in the circuit, LC circuit, and therefore there is a frequency of oscillations. It has some frequency. These are called as the LC oscillations. LC ठिकाणी आपण काय म्हणतो, LC oscillations म्हणतो. This is called as the LC oscillation. There is no loss of energy in this oscillation. Amplitude of oscillations remains constant and oscillations are undamped. Oscillations कशी असतील, undamped असतील. म्हणजे जे एम्प्लिट्यूड आहे ते कसं राहणार आहे, कॉन्स्टंट राहणार आहे. ऑसिलेशनचं एम्प्लिट्यूड कॉन्स्टंट असणार आहे म्हणजेच काय झालं, याचं मिनिंग द ऑसिलेशन्स आर अनडॅम्प्ड. डॅम्प्ड ऑसिलेशन्स मध्ये एम्प्लिट्यूड जे आहे ते अशा पद्धतीने कमी कमी होत जातं. दिस इज द डॅम्प्ड ऑसिलेशन. आणि अनडॅम्प्ड ऑसिलेशन्स मध्ये जे एम्प्लिट्यूड आहे ऑसिलेशनचं ते कसं राहणार, कॉन्स्टंट राहणार आहे. दिस इज कॉल्ड एज द अनडॅम्प्ड ऑसिलेशन्स प्रोड्युसेस इन द this circuit. Every inductor has same resistance. This causes energy loss as heat, and amplitude of oscillation goes on decreasing and they finally die out. But या ठिकाणी इंडक्टरला रेजिस्टन्स असेल तर ड्यू टू दिस रेजिस्टन्स द एनर्जी लॉस अँड ड्यू टू द लॉस इन एनर्जी द एम्प्लिट्यूड गोज ऑन डिक्रीजेस अँड ऑसिलेशन्स बिकम्स डॅम्प्ड अँड देअरफॉर द इवन इफ रेजिस्टन्स वेअर झिरो द टोटल एनर्जी ऑफ सिस्टीम वुड नॉट बी रिमेन्स कॉन्स्टंट. इट इज रिएडिटेड अवे इन द फॉर्म ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमॅग्नेटिक वेव्स. द वर्किंग ऑफ टीव्ही and radio transmitter is based around this such type of radiations. And this is the LC oscillation. Okay, thank you.